Hello creators! Ready to take your video editing game to the next level? After this tutorial, you'll master the exposure blur transition. Let's get started. Create a new project and add your video files using drag and drop or the Add Object button. For this tutorial, we are decreasing the duration of the video files to 3 seconds, but you can select the duration that works for you. Now, select files on the timeline, click them using the right mouse button and convert them into a sprite. Move over to the Properties window and change Sprite Object settings. Select No in the field named Use as Container and switch to Yes mode in the field named Show Effects. Finally, select No for the field background parameter. Next, go to the Video Effects tab, proceed to Filters and select Gaussian Blur. The duration of this effect can be as brief as half a second. Now move the effect to the moment on the timeline where video files join and place the cursor in the center of it. Go to the Properties window and find Blur Levels. Select Parameter Change along a Trajectory mode as we are demonstrating and then click the three-dot icon right next to it. You will see that the timeline now includes a trajectory. Make a double-click where your cursor is located to add a control point to the trajectory and drag it to the top. This way you can regulate how strong the blurring effect will be. Perfect! Now go back to the Sprite tab on the timeline. Here, go to the Video Effects tab, proceed to Adjustments and select Brightness, Contrast, Gamma. The same way we did it previously, adjust the duration and the location of the effect on the timeline and place the cursor in the center of it. In the Properties window, we need to set up gamma levels. Repeat actions you performed for the first time. Select Parameter Change along a Trajectory mode, click the three-dot icon right next to it, create a control point on the trajectory and drag it to the top. Let's preview the result. As you can see, at the transition moment it gets blurred and becomes brighter as we expected it to. However, you can still see the joining moment, so let's go ahead and make this transition even smoother. Select the Gaussian blur and the BCG effects on the timeline and drag them to the end of the first video. Move the second video to the level below and align it with the beginning of the effects. Now click the first video and apply the fade-out effect to it. You will find it if you go to Video Effects and select Transparency. Reduce the fade-out effect duration to half a second. And align it with the end of the video. That's it! The exposure blur transition is ready. Did you like our tutorial? Then give us a thumbs up and let us know what else you'd like to learn in the comments below.